John Mark, WTOB out of Winston-Salem. It's 15 past the hour and snow's in the forecast. That would be a nice early Christmas present. Let's get into the spirit with the sound of the season. Merry Christmas, everybody.
All right, you chipmunks. Ready to sing your song?
I'll say we are. Yeah, let's sing it now.
Okay, Simon.
Okay.
Okay, Theodore.
Okay.
Okay, Alvin. Alvin.
Hey, Xavier.
Yeah?
Hey, listen, man, I don't want to sound like a downer here or anything, but considering the circumstances, how much you want to bet that this girl of yours isn't even going to show up tonight, man?
Uncle Theo, she pulls this shit all the time. Don't you remember Grandma's anniversary party?
Yeah, I remember that. I remember. But, you know, I just figured she'd be like most people and be here when she said she'd be here. I mean, I don't know, am I alone in thinking that if you're going to pursue a life of crime that... you know, it'd be a kind of common sense to make punctuality a, I don't know, gigantic factor in whether or not you're going to pull off one of your schemes?
No, not unless you're a bank robber or something.
Look, man, I want her to show up just as much as you do, okay? You think I want to be paying this off for the next 5 years?
Paying off a broken leg for the next 5 years? What are you, Hobo Joe?
Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. I forgot how world-weary a 22-year-old is. No, I get it. But, you know, you just wait. Wait till you have a mortgage and a wife to support. And a business to run. Eventually, life itself will come crashing down on you like one big, giant avalanche.
All right.
So, you said you had something to say of the utmost importance?
Yeah, I do. I may have exaggerated a bit, but yeah.
911, what's your emergency?
Hi, this is Theodore Moltisanti. I run the Omega House over on Peters Creek.
Okay, are you gonna leave me in suspense, or?
Well, that's kind of the problem. I really don't know how to start all this since it's been like a year since we've seen each other.
It seems as though Amanda Riviera has come into my place of business. Yes, that Amanda Riviera, I'm sure of it.
I knew this was going to be awkward, so I'm just going to come out there and say it. I've been thinking a lot about us.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's haunting me. I'm a new man now. I'm like half the jackass I was back then, believe it or not. And I just wanted to say that no matter what I said or what I did or who I did it with, I genuinely, from the bottom of my heart, loved you.
Is that it?
Yeah, that's pretty much it. I thought you're not crying. I thought you'd be crying.
Let me get this straight. You called me after, I don't know, about a year of one-sided silence just to get me to come all the way back to the boonies of North Carolina so that you could tell me you loved me?
Well, when you say it like that, it's a little absurd, but kind of.
Okay, which one is it, Xavier? Do you A, actually pine for me in this incredibly romantic Hallmark card way, or are you just B, really incredibly desperately horny right now?
What?
Because
what?
I mean, if
no,
so,
no.
This is by
no,
far the
no,
most
no, no, no,
pathetic
no.
way I've ever been approached.
My state of horniness has nothing to do with anything right now. You know what? I'm a little offended that when I try to express my genuine romantic
genuine?
Feelings.
Are you kidding me? A load of bullshit doesn't substitute for a declaration of the utmost importance.
All right, listen, I don't know what's going on here.
Listen, Xavier, do me a favor, okay? Can you answer me in complete honesty?
I don't know. Look, where's my uncle?
Why did you do it?
Do what?
Look, I know. I know that until you found out about the $50,000 bounty hanging over my head, that I hadn't been a fleeting thought for you in months. I came here because I thought that maybe, despite everything, maybe you were actually being sincere on the phone there. But no, of course not. You couldn't even if you wanted to, right? There'd be no point. Come on, Xavier, you can admit it. Seriously, You have nothing to say at all? Fine. Whatever, I think I said my piece anyways.
What are you doing? What is that? Amanda, who are you trying to call?
Just wait. I'll see.
Amanda, I'm not joking around. Who are you trying to call?
Xavier! Xavier, get the phone! She's got a bomb, man!
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird. Here to stay is the new bird. He sings a love song as we go along. Walking in a winter.